In this video, I'm going to show you how to import data from a text file. Now, you can import data from a lot of different types of files, Access files, any type of database files. But this in particular is just a video over text files. And those would be files that are saved with a TXT extension. So you can see that I have a sheet called Import Data. So you want to make sure you have a blank sheet ready to go. So we're going to go to the Data tab. And from the Data tab, you'll see over here in the Get External Data section, you have a lot of different ways you can bring that data in from an Access file, from the web, even other sources. So if you have a specific program that you use at work and it's not, you know, an Access file or it's not coming from the internet or a text file, then you may want to explore the options that you have in this button or command. So I'm going to go ahead and click on From Text. And then I'm going to navigate to where my text file has been saved. And in this case, this one is called employees.txt. So you want to select the file and then click on the import button. Now at this point, you're going to have the text import wizard dialog box. This is going to take you through the steps. So you have a total of three steps. So this first part is showing you how the original data is actually in that text file. Delimited means what are the character or characters that separate each piece of information in that file. Now, please keep in mind, if you're not the creator of that file, then this is something you're still going to see down here in the view screen or the preview of the file, but you still may have to do some additional editing once you bring the text into Excel. So we can see that we have the first and last name with only a space separation. Then we have a comma. We have the street address, comma. We have the city, state, and zip, but there's nothing separating it other than a space. So this is going to end up being in one cell or in one column, and then we'll just use some functions to split that up. Then this looks like it is probably a social security number. And then we have a date and then some other information. So it looks like the common delimiter here is going to be a comma. So I'm going to stick with delimited. Now if we do fixed width, this means fields are aligned in columns with spaces between each. And I'm not going to go for that right now, but I always say explore and see what works best. Now my data has headers. This does not, because you can see there's not a row there that identifies each piece of information. But if we did have a file where there was a first row had each piece of information in there, then we would click on my data has a header. So we're going to leave that turned off. Now we're going to go ahead and start the import from the very first row. File origin, this is something you usually don't have to mess with. It's something that automatically is identified based on how the file was saved as far as the file format. So we're going to click on next. Now this is where you identify the type of delimiter. Delimiter again is just identifying what character, usually a non-printing character, that separates each of the fields. Now you can have multiple ones. So this one says tab, but we actually have a comma. So I'm going to turn tab off and choose comma. And notice once I select a comma, Excel went through and actually scanned the data in that file and is giving you an idea of how it's going to separate the information. So once it came across a comma, it created a column. After the street address, it created a column, and then we have the city, state, and zip, and we'll use some text functions to separate these three pieces of information. So it looks like the one that's going to give me the best results is going to be a comma. So we're going to go ahead and click next. Now this last step, the screen lets you select each column and set the data format. I usually don't mess with that. That's something I'll do within Excel once I bring the data in. So we're going to go ahead and click finish. And now it's asking where would you like to put this, and I just use the first row, the first cell. I can always add rows and columns later on. I can do a new worksheet if I want to, but I'm already on this sheet. Add this data to the data model. That's something that's more advanced that we're not going to be working with as far as data models. So we're going to go ahead and click OK. And now you have the data. So at this point, I would probably go ahead and add a row, and then I would work with some text functions to separate the three pieces of information in here. And that's how you import text from another source into Excel.